Hello, dear viewers. Today I've got this. This is a really cheap watercolor set with paper in size A4. And here's the price. It's €3.99. It's almost €4. And it's, well, the paper, this tiny box of watercolors. And, okay, the paper isn't as heavy. It's 180 GSM. But, well, I just want to test this out as a starter set. And, well, I like this little watercolor box. Look at how tiny it is. I just had to get it, and even if I don't like the colors, I can just take them out and refill it with my own colors. Well, and the paper, I don't know, I will test it. I hope it's not that bad. I hate those wrappers. Okay, so I've got this in a German store named Norma. And, well, I saw it, it was pretty cheap. And I guess you could see this as a cheap watercolor or art supply challenge, because I'm going to try this stuff out. And this stuff only, the only additional thing I'm going to add is water, because that's the only thing that didn't come with it. And, well, let's open this. How does it look inside? And it looks extremely cheap. But, well, I guess it was extremely cheap, and I said I'm probably going to take them out and use this with better watercolors. So there are no names in this, but it doesn't matter. Well, it doesn't seem to lose hair, but it doesn't have a fine tip, so I guess the brush would be the first thing to replace. Oh, okay. The paper does look quite thick. It feels awkward. So let's swatch the colors out. Okay, and I think I need to pre-wet them, sorry. I'm going to use this little spray bottle here. They look quite chalky, like those cool watercolors I used back in school. And, well, the brand is Paperscript, if this even is a proper brand name. Okay. I think I'm going to place it like this. Let me see. Yes, looks okay. I tend to put the back of the brush in my mouth if I'm holding it and need my hands. And this one tastes pretty awful. This set seems to be produced in China. So, well, I'm not going to say that Chinese products are bad, but some are, because they are pretty cheaply produced, and this one really is cheaply produced. I think I'm going to destroy the brush while swatching out the colors, because this really is... Oh, this takes so long. Well, I think those five are the same colors, and this two might be the same. No, I think this one's darker. So, okay, maybe I didn't clean the brush properly. No. Maybe it's just a really ugly color. I would have said it's something like May Green from Schmincke or something like this. But on the paper it looks more grayish, which could be the paper. It is kind of gray. The orange. Oh no. I have no idea how I'm going to produce art with this one. Okay, the paper seems to bleed, I guess. And the yellow ochre looks, well, it's wet, almost like the orange. And now the red. It's a warm red. No primary red, it seems. Okay. So, there are definitely no watercolors like in, you know, like the one you got from Schmincke and stuff. In Germany, we have a different word for those watercolors than for the other ones, like Schmincke, Daniel Smith, and brands like this, like those produce, and we call those more professional watercolors aquarellfarben, and the other ones were Wasserfarben, which is watercolors, just watercolors. So, and those are kids' watercolors. Okay, later I'm going to analyze these colors a bit more, like what kind of watercolors they are. Not the kind, color names. Okay, let's see, this one looks like a mix between ultramarine and indigo, so it's a darker than ultramarine, but not as dark as indigo, I think. They are really chalky, and this one could be a bit, it looks a bit like Prussian blue. This could be a burnt umber. No, this looks more like burnt umber. This is a darker burnt umber, I don't know. I'm really bad with color names. I'm going to get my swatches. Here I am, and let's see. At first we've got no proper yellow, which is kind of odd. We've got a white, a black, and this one seems like, I said, a May green, but a dirtier one. And maybe that's because of the paper here. And this looks like Naples yellow reddish. Next one I would say is a yellow ochre. Then we have a red. Let's see what we've got here. It looks something like a dirty perlin red deep. That's the closest I have. And for the browns, this one looks something, it looks like a bit warmer and creamier sepia, and this one like a more reddish burnt umber, or maybe more like a, yeah, I think those one are closer, like a Caput Mortem and a Burnt Umber mix. The blues are, well, I think, like I said, this one looks a bit like a Prussian blue. Huh. Here you go. But it's a bit more like, it's a, like a mix between Prussian blue and Colleen blue or phthalo blue. So, yeah. This absolutely looks like Prussian blue. I think this is the Prussian blue and this one is more like a phthalo-like blue. And this one is just some kind of violet. And, well, this looks like a phthalo green or viridian or such a stupid word, sorry. Okay. Now, what do we do with those cheap colors? I'm going to get a pencil and try to do a little landscape. So, here we go. Oh. Going to change the setup a bit, and I'm also going to add a bigger brush because I'm going to do a sky and it will be hard with the smaller one. So, I'm pretty much just drawing what I see outside of my window. Now let's start with the sky. I'm going to take a lighter blue, this one, mix of this, I think. All in all, they seem quite boring. Let's shade the clouds a bit. The paper is warping quite a bit, but I don't mind it much because I actually expected worse. It's a bit more green here. No, I feel like I am back in school. These colors aren't good. They aren't any good. I'm just, like I said, going to take them out and replace them with colors I like more. And yeah, also with colors I can mix better. I mean, they don't perform well. So let's have here a bit lighter green because I want it like this. So here we go. And let's see, what did I paint here? Here's a gap, and here's a gap, and here's a gap. And I'm going to use a bit more blue here. Okay, I'm using the bright green as a mixing, for mixing, because I don't have yellows. This is so stupid. How can you not put a yellow in a palette? That's ridiculous. Even for a kid's palette, you need some yellow. Or is this supposed to be yellow? It doesn't look yellow. To me it looks green. Okay, now that it's dried, it looks a bit more like yellow, but the palette, I mean, look at this. This is just some kind of green. Maybe it's just supposed to be a, I don't know, cool green and a warm green, a warm yellow, I mean yellow, not green. Ah, sorry. So, now I'm going to do the bridge. I'm going to do the base with some burnt umber and a yellow ochre mix. Ugh. This is no fun. It's not the right color, but it's so damn hard to get a yellow ochre from the palette. Okay, what's missing? The roof and... I think those are parts of the paper which I scrubbed off with the brush, okay. And now the shadows here. Kind of. I totally messed up the perspective. But whatever, for testing out, I guess it's okay. And now I need to use some white and orange to mix the color of the house. It's hard to get pigments out of the brush, really. Normally I'm not having as much problems with stuff like this. What's a bit good about this colors? These colors is that I don't have to wait for them to dry as much, because they act more like gouache and don't float into each other this much. So I'm going to be able to finish this painting sooner. Now, just look at this. Only this much came off. Oh. Well. I think this can be a good thing, because those colors are going to last you for like eternity. Oh, I'm just going to use pure red, that's it. I'm giving up on mixing anything here, because it's so much work. You cannot really scrub the colors off the paper, but I don't think this thing with the colors. It's more a paper thing. And you don't see me doing this here. Okay, I just realized that. So here we go. And... ta-da! I'm done. I'm done with this painting, and I'm done with this palette. Wait, I forgot the windows. So, not here. Look at me. This looks like garbage. Okay, I totally wouldn't recommend these colors. The paper is, well, I guess you can work with it. And a little tip, don't put your water this close, because you are going to spray your painting. This happens to me quite often, to be honest. I don't know why I don't change what I do. Okay, and this brush, let's see. It's really dirty and it doesn't seem to get clean again. Ah, okay. My other brush didn't get as dirty, I think. So, now let's see, what am I going to do? I'm going to take this, and I'm going to take the colors out. I'm not sure, I'm probably going to throw it away, because I'm not going to do anything with these colors and refill them with stuff I like. So, till... later to... well, I'm going to clean this palette now. Bye. So I'm back and I've cleaned it out. Now that I look back on it, it said 18 different colors and one brush, but those weren't 18 different colors. I mean, those are the same. Maybe I'm not able to count properly. Okay, let's just count before I say something stupid. 1, 2, 3, 4. 13. Okay. Those... actually sticked to worlds with Clue. I didn't get Clue out properly, but I'm just going to ignore this now because I think I'm going to destroy it if I clean it more. Ugh. So now, let's see. Here we go. And now we have to decide on yes, 18 worlds. We have to decide on 18 colors we are going to take, which is why I brought my tube colors here in this box. I like this box. It has butterflies on it. So let's see. At first I think I'm going to make, you know, the usual, just look what kind of primaries I take, and let's see what kind of tube yellows I have here. Van Gogh. I don't think I'm going to use Van Gogh colors, not because I don't like them, but I already have a palette with them, and okay, I think I'm going to take them out anyway. So here we go, and I think I have already decided on my blues. Well, for the blues I'm going to take a phthalo blue from Schmincke, a delft blue from Schmincke, and ultramarine deep from Michello. So two non-granulating blues and one heavily granulating blue. Okay, what else? This one is the Gamboge Modern. Okay, Gummy Good. Okay, I'm definitely going to take this one as a warm yellow, and this is a green yellow, and okay, let's see where I have this. I think it's in the greens. I want this color in my palette, but I'm not sure if I want it for a cool yellow. I'm probably going to take it for a cool yellow, but well, I don't have as much colors in here anymore. I use my Van Gogh colors a lot. Van Gogh. I'm just going to say Van Gogh. The rest sounds kind of stupid. Okay, let's see. I want a burnt umber and a burnt sienna in here. Okay. And a Van Dyke brown. Okay, I've got 6 colors, 7, 8. I mean, 18 worlds, there's more to go. And now reds. I don't have much reds. I think, why do I have... Most reds I have are actually from my essential set. Or my I don't have them in tubes, I have them in pans. Acridone deep gold, there's not much left in here. Those are so small. I like them for trying them out, because if it's a color you don't like, you don't have much of it, but if it's a color you like, you will be sad because it's empty so fast. This is the only red I have as a tube from not Van Gogh. Okay. Oh, that's not true. I also have these sets here. But they are also small. So, for the reds, what am I going to do? I'm going to take this one as a warm red, and this one as my cool red. Yes. I could just use my Daniel Smith colors. Huh, that's hard. That's hard. I mean, this is PB19, and this is pretty much the standard cool red. It's just Schminke has, I think, 2 PB19 reds. So I'm going to take the reds from my Daniel Smith set. Okay, let's start, I guess. I could also add this one. I have to count how many colors I have. Okay, let's see. 2 yellows, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14? I have 14 colors. That's not enough. Okay, let's see what else. I think I've got a paint gray there and a Potter's pink. You can never have enough Potter's pink. Or I'm just going to fill in some double. Okay, let's just start. So now the reds. I'm still not sure if I want to use my Daniel Smith colors. They were really expensive, but Pyrrole Scarlet and Crinacridone Rose. I think I should swatch them out while I'm doing them. Hey, let's see how the backside of this paper works. So let's rip this out, and I don't even wanna try. So let's see. I think I'm going to take the ruby red and do something else with my way too expensive Daniel Smith watercolors. Do you also have this problem that you rather use your cheap stuff than your expensive one? I know in a lot of countries Schmincke also isn't it's not a cheap brand, but in Germany it's way cheaper than Daniel Smith, because that's where it's made. Okay. Okay, this Ultramarine Deep is the only Micello color I've got. It's highly granulating, which is why I want it in my palette, because the other two Schmincke colors are pretty much non-granulating. And the Delft Blue. I like this one. It doesn't have the highest light fastness Schmincke has. It has 4 out of 5, but I love this color. Just look at how deep it is. I love Burnt Umber. It's such a nice color. It's one of my favorite browns. I know a lot of people say you only need like 6 colors or 3, but most say 6, and that's 6 primaries, you know, a cold and a warm of each one, and well, you don't need more, but it's a lot more comfortable if you have more colors. I mean, if you want to learn how to mix colors, I would recommend you to start with just the primaries. It's quite nice, and then, you know, go on from that one and see what you need. I know I've got 3 browns on my palette, and I'm going to add 2 colors which are more or less black. I'm such a lazy person, I use paint spray a lot, and it's I could just mix it, and that's one of those things. That's what I mean with you will know which colors you need later on, and those colors are, well, they are most of the time, at least for me, be lazy colors. Colors which I use because I'm too lazy to mix them. Which one first? Paint spray or neutral tint? Okay. I'll start with paint spray from Winsor & Newton Professionals. I like the Professionals, they are good. I was afraid to try them out because I didn't like the Cottmans as much. But they are good, they are nice colors. So let's see. Look at this nice paint spray. It's more like a really dark blue, different from the paint spray from Van Gogh. So here we go. That's it, I'm not going to paint with this now because, well, I think I'm going to let it dry first. Tomorrow I will see if I can do something with these colors on that paper, and if not, like I said, I'm going to use it as sketching paper. Maybe cut it in parts and bind it with my spiral binder, which I also used on this one. It's quite a handy tool, and this is also really bad watercolor paper. That's what I do with my bad papers. I just cut them in parts and bind them. So now, we've waited a day for the paint to dry. It's not fully dry yet. It's still kind of squishy if you put your finger on it, but it's enough to use it for painting. And I've also discovered something else about these colors. They rub off. I don't know if you can see it, but my fingers kind of blue. Okay, now I think you can see it. Yes, I can see it on a mini display. So okay, now let's compare this. Let's see if the paper is at least worth something. Okay, I just adjust the camera a bit, so, okay, better, I think, and I'm pretty much going to use the same motif I've used last time, so I can really compare them. I hope I will do better this time, because last time I had a lot of problems getting the values right because of the paint. Here we go, that's pretty much how it looks. Just a lot of trees here. I just painted true into my pillar. Great job. okay, that was right, but that was wrong. Okay. Pillar. Not a pillar. So here we go, pillar. Not a pillar. And here. So now I've got it, I think. Whatever. So I'm going to start with the sky. Today it's actually gray, but I'm going to take blue anyway, because, well, I want them to be comparable, and I'm going to take the phthalo blue for the sky, and I think I'm going to mix it with a bit ultramarine from Micello here to get a bit of granulation. The paper is still not the best, but it's already a lot better than it used to be with the cheap paints. It reminds me a bit of my last moleskin. It's worse than the moleskin, but the moleskin also tended to soak in the colors like this. I tend to do this a lot, where I'm just, you know, making a blob of paint onto the paper and then wash it out. And this isn't working with this paper, I'm sorry. The colors don't float quite well on this paper. It's that was a pillar. no. Let's wash the color off. I don't think it's going to work. Not really. Doesn't matter. It will end up being darker anyway. If you're seeing the colors right, I'm painting the window. It already does look a lot better. and I didn't have such a hard time scrubbing off the colors from the pans. The palette itself is quite nice. I'm definitely going to use it as a travel palette, because it has a really nice size. Yes, that's a lot closer to the actual color than what I did with the last paints from the set. Didn't clean the brush properly, so. And it doesn't lift off. It's just bleeding in and doesn't lift off. Whatever. And it's bleeding again, and I haven't cleaned my brush properly again. I'm having a bad day, and this paper won't let me lift off the colors. Okay, I think I'm just letting this rest and do the bridge now. I think I'm going to leave it this way. Okay, here. Normal watercolors did work a lot better on the paper, but it still didn't perform quite well. It's soaking the colors into the paper pretty much. It's not forgiving or anything, it's just, well, cheap paper. My favorite part of the set is this tiny case where I filled in my own colors, which are already dirty, especially the yellow here. I'm going to clean it up a bit. Come here. Alright, just put it here. I'm going to use this at some point. I always use leftover colors from my palette. I don't like to waste colors this much. So that's it. $3.99. I didn't expect much. I didn't get much. I guess for the price, you cannot complain. Okay, the colors were total shit. They didn't lift off the pens, and well, that could have been a bit better or easier to lift off. And in the end, I've got some sketching paper and some nice tin, and I've looked on the internet, and those things usually are a bit more expensive, well, those cases, so, and you don't get this inlay with the pens or the tiny welds. So if you want to do this by yourself, buying each piece individual, the pens to put in and this tin, it will probably be more expensive than buying the set. Then on the other hand, you can get yourself a nicer tin and, well, this does look cheap a bit, but it's okay for me. I like it. I think I'm going to put this into my bag when all the colors are 100% dry and I don't have to be afraid for them to run out anymore. And so that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope the light is okay. I haven't painted in daylight much for a pretty long time, since I didn't have any actual daylight in my last apartment. It was really dark in there and depressing, and now I've got a window again with a nice sign, and I'm really happy, and I hope I will be able to paint a lot more for you when I'm done with my bachelor, which I'm writing at the moment. And goodbye till next time.